Hello learners, with today's greeting, I am Professor Naseeb Singh Gill from Department of Computer Science and Applications and Director Digital Learning Initiatives and Monitoring Cell of Maharishi Dayanand University, Rohtak, Haryana. The 21st century has become the era of digital transformations because today's digital world technology has hugely influenced every aspect of our lives. In our homes, workplaces, schools, colleges, universities, throughout industries and society as a whole, technology enables dramatic shifts in how we live, work, and communicate. But the digital technology has not changed how human beings learn. It has fundamentally changed the range of tools and techniques we can use to assist our learning, but it does not necessarily make us smarter. Therefore, we need to match that development with the right kind of tools to the specific learning needs. Having discussed in previous modules about several other technology-supported pedagogical innovations, including cloud computing, mobile computing, Internet of Things, smart computing and smart learning. So now let's step forward and discuss the next module of this program, which is hybrid learning and learning analytics technology. First of all, let's have a look at the learning outcomes of the present module. By the end of this module, learners will be able to understand personalized learning, the benefits of technology-aided personalized learning, the concept of blended and hybrid learning, the benefits of blended and hybrid learning, the concept of learning management system, and the learner's benefit of this learning management system, the concept of learning analytics and its benefits, then role of web-based tools in learning, and finally, the evolution of web-based tools such as Web 1.0 to Web 4.0. So first of all, let's discuss what is personalized learning. Personalized learning is one of the most popular terms in educational technology. But the same is used in so many different ways. Most educators may agree to the fact that personalized learning is most important. And it is a top priority for learning communities across the world. But what exactly does personalized learning mean? How can you bring personalized learning to your classroom in a genuine, meaningful, and transformative manner? Personalized learning refers to instruction in which the pace of learning and the instructional approach are optimized for the needs of each learner. Learning objectives, instructional approaches, and instruction content and its sequences may all vary based on learner needs. In addition, learning activities are made available that are meaningful and relevant to learners, driven by their interest and which are often self-initiated. So personalized learning is not a new concept, but the emergence of classroom technology has made it easier for educators to develop and deliver such student-centered lessons. Personalized learning should not be confused with other learnings, where each definition overlaps in at least one key areas with personalized learning. Let's take up adaptive learning. Adaptive learning technology is used to assign human or digital resources to learners based on their unique needs. Similarly, if you talk about individualized learning, the pace of learning is adjusted to meet the needs of individual students in this kind of learning. In case of differentiated learning approach, our learning is adjusted to the needs of individual students. So, you would have now got the understanding of our personalized learning and how it is different from the rest learnings. Now, let's learn about the benefits of personalized learning through technology. This is one of the areas in which the personalized learning model greatly benefits teachers and students alike, because this model drives academic achievements and personal growth. Deliver instruction through engaging forms of media, including videos, audio clips, and interactive games. It gives students more options beyond the traditional essay, poster, or report. It uses digital tools to gather immediate feedback on students' understanding and use the information to customize subsequent lessons. It facilitates design thinking. Personalized learning, design thinking, and project-based learning often go hand in hand. Design thinking is being used in healthcare, business, education, and other fields as a strategic problem-solving method involving stakeholders. Project-based learning is focused on driving students to research, encounter, and interact with the central concepts and principles of a particular discipline or topic. Within design thinking and project-based learning, classrooms, technology puts students in more active and engaging roles with regard to their education. It streamlines differentiated learning. One goal of personalized learning plan is giving students time to explore subjects that interest them in ways that work best for them. Educators are coming to understand that every student in a classroom possesses a unique set of talents and interests. When each student is allowed to shine in his or her own unique way, your classroom culture will become more positive and students will be encouraged to do better on each successive project. Before we discuss about blended or hybrid learning, let's first understand the cognitive process of learning. In brief, the cognitive process of learning has four basic stages. Number one, attention stage. Attention stage, it filters through which we experience the world. Second stage, encoding. How we process what our attention admits into the minds. Third stage, storage. What happens once information enters the brain. And fourth stage is the retrieval, the recall of that information or behavior. Now, let's understand what is hybrid learning. Is it different from blended learning or flipped classroom learning? What are its benefits? Over the past two decades, advances in the area of web and video content delivery have aided the growth of technology-based teaching and learning methodologies. However, the terminology can be as new as the technology. Now let's understand what is blended learning. Blended learning is a kind of education that takes place both online and offline. That is traditional setup. Both of these modalities are integrated into a cohesive learning experience for the students. In blended learning scenarios, face-to-face, FaceTime between student and teachers is not replaced by online course delivery. Rather, the online component of the learning experience usually consists of exercises or additional content that complement the in-class lesson. After understanding blended learning, let's look how your blended learning is different from hybrid learning. So in the nutshell, what exactly is your hybrid learning? Often the term hybrid learning is used almost interchangeably with blended learning. However, there is subtle distinction. In hybrid learning, a significant portion of the course takes place online. In contrast with blended learning, a hybrid learning scenario replaces much of the student-teacher FaceTime in an offline traditional setup with online interaction. Now, let's look how your blended learning and hybrid learning are different from flipped classroom learning. The flipped classroom is another kind of blended learning where a student is first exposed to new material outside of class, usually in the form of an online presentation. When the student attends class in an offline traditional setting, the class time is used to apply the material in the form of problem solving and discussion. After understanding hybrid and blended learning, now let's take a stock of the benefits of these learnings. The hybrid modalities provides significant benefits for learners, instructors, and training organizations. These benefits include to all the stakeholders. Let's pinpoint the learner benefits. Number one, increased interaction with instructor. Number two, greater engagement and involvement in the course. Number three, higher quality peer interaction. Number four, greater flexibility in course scheduling. Now let's pinpoint the benefits to instructors. Number one, better student engagement, more flexible scheduling, ability to reach more learners, and finally, interactive teaching environment. Our training organizations are also benefited, like cost-effective way to extend the reach of training and improved learning experience for more effective training. So these were the benefits. Now, let's understand the philosophy and the concept of learning management system and what is learning analytics and how are these helpful. So first of all, let's understand what is learning management system. A learning management system is a software-based platform that facilitates the management, delivery, and measurement of an organization's e-learning programs. The learning management system has become an incredibly powerful tool for organizations looking to improve the performance and retention of its stakeholders. Most learning management systems are cloud-based software solutions that facilitate organizations and use as the foundation of their training programs. Now, let's understand what is learning content management system and how it is different from learning management system. Learning content management system is a software that helps developers and administrators build and manage e-learning content. It is different from a learning management system as they don't provide the features learning administrators actually need to deliver that content and track the performance of their learners. How learning management system benefits its learners? There are several benefits of learning management system to learners because it engages with formal and informal learning best practices. It increases knowledge retention. It improves performance. It empowered to embrace self-improvement. It stay on top of required learning. And it also helps to acquire skills and knowledge. Next in the series is to learn learning analytics. What is this kind of technology? Any good learning management software relies on learning analytics to help personalize teaching methods. Learning analytics is nothing but the measurement and dissection of data about learners used to optimize their learning experience. It sounds like the teaching methods of tomorrow, and in true terms, in many ways, it is. Now let's take a stock of the learning analytics benefits. The benefits of using learning analytics are amazing. And few of these benefits include, number one, individual attention. With learning analytics, the individual attention deficiencies are identified immediately and remedial measures are initiated accordingly. Number two, performance prediction. Learning analytics can predict whether or not a student will pass or will perform in the remainder of the course. If they pass, analytics can predict in which areas they will still need additional support. Number three, cost effective. Learning analytics is quite cost effective as it helps in avoiding wastage of time and money on methods that don't help a particular student who learns at different pace. Number four, improved retention rate. Students' retention rate is improved as learning analytics serve to improve current learning difficulties and predict future failures. Now let's understand what is the role of web-based tools in learning. Blended learning is more than just combining an online component to the traditional classroom. It is a systematic process of selecting the most appropriate media for a specific learning intervention based upon the learning objectives. With that said, given the plethora of instructional media available to the instructional designers today, combined with the emergence of web-based collaborative tools, there is a renewed focus on integrating web tools. That could be our web 1.0 to what web 4.0 or 5.0 e-learning tools and other instructional media in meeting today's learning challenges. So now let's understand web-based collaborative tools and their evolution. And web-based tools evolved from web 1.0 to what web 4.0. As the number of internet users increased daily, the web and internet were redesigned and changed through the years. The era up to 1990, which included desktops, file systems, file servers, file transfer protocols, is known as PC era. So, what is web 1.0? Web 1.0, it remained during 1990 to 2000, which is also known as information web. Web 1.0 was the first generation of the World Wide Web, and it was primarily read-only and static. Web 1.0 was primarily used by organizations and personal websites, which only showed information. In the year 2000, Web 1.0 transitioned to read and write web, which was known as Web 2.0. And Web 2.0, it was scattered over 2000 to 2010. And it is also known as social web. So Web 2.0 was the second generation of the World Wide Web. Here, users were able to not only read websites, but also interact and connect with other users. Applications are all social media, such as blogs, Facebook, Wiki, Flickr, YouTube, and many more emerged with Web 2.0. And Web 2.0 included several content types, such as audio, blogging, calendars, customer relationship management, e-learning, email, forms, knowledge base, multimedia portals, and games. People were able to participate, collaborate on ideas, share information, and generate information that was available to the whole world. So Web 2.0 was present up to 2010, and then it slowly transitioned and evolved into Web 3.0. And Web 3.0 is also known as Semantic Web, and which is likely up to the year 2020. So it is nothing but it is a third generation of World Wide Web, which is called Web 3.0. It is also known as Read, Write, and Execute Web. It is open, intelligent, with semantic web technologies, distributed data sources, natural language processing, machine learning processing. Computers can interpret information like humans and intelligently generate and distribute useful content tailored to the needs of users. It includes transforming the web into a database, a move towards making content accessible by multiple non-browser applications, the leveraging of artificial intelligence technologies. Technologies of this included XML, URI, API, RDF, OWF, auth, etc. Further, this technology evolved into another web technology that is called Web 4.0 or 5.0, which is also known as intelligent web or symbiotic web. So that is expected that beyond 2020, the era is likely to come. It will be next generation of web called Web 4.0 or 5.0, which will be intelligent web. It is intelligent learning. It will be providing self-learning. It will be self-organizing, which will connect all devices in the real and virtual world in real time. Now, what will be the face of Web 5.0? This web will have emotional connection between humans and computers. It will identify and perceive emotions and will respond to our emotions accordingly. So in this way, we have taken a stock of all kind of web technologies and your all kind of our this learning analytics and their benefits and that kind of technology. I hope that you would have enjoyed the present module on hybrid learning and learning analytics technology, which plays again a very significant role in pedagogical innovations. We will join you soon with another module in this series focused on technology-supported pedagogical innovations. Thank you very much.